Got breaking news for you. Actor Peter Fonda issuing an apology just a few moments ago, Of course, this is for that inappropriate and vulgar tweet that I'm sure almost everyone has seen today with regard to President Trump's son, Barron. Fonda telling Fox News that it's a long apology, but ultimately he's apparently, after even the publicist seemed to double down, trying to make some form of amends. But it brings us to the big question about this double standard that has haunted the Trump administration from everything, including this issue of the children being separated from their families. Here to discuss, we have Lawrence Jones, the campus reform editor-in-chief. Lawrence, first let's talk about what, you know, these images, these children, these heartbreaking images. Really, you can't defend them. No one could defend them. It was tough for anyone to even try or suggest. But we saw over the last week or so where often there were images taken when President Obama was in office and presented as fresh new images of atrocities that were occurring under President Trump. It's really difficult to find solutions or to even have honest conversation when the media is doing this kind of stuff all the time.
Yeah, and Charles, honestly, I am always sympathetic when children are involved. But again, there are laws in this country. When Hillary Clinton had her policy of the super predators and Bill Clinton went after the drug dealers in our community and they were ripped away from their families, there were no tears over that. And so I don't understand why in America we now have a double standard for lawbreaking. I mean, I got some tears, too, in my community for things that took place. But the law is the law. Either you go and you fight for reforms like I'm doing for criminal justice, for laws that I don't like and hope that someday it's repealed and they get reunited with their family, or you can believe in lawlessness and people can do whatever the hell they want to do and cross the border.
Now, when you say for your community, you know what, hold on one second, because I also want to bring in Kelly Jane Torrance, of course, the Weekly Standard, the deputy managing editor. Kelly Jane, you've been extremely active with respect to this whole, how this whole thing has played out. You know, we know, of course, there have been some double standards, and we know there have been some old images that are shown. We also understand what's happened here over the last 2 weeks, forcing, in part, President Trump to do this executive order today. But does it go too far? Does the double standard in the media, does it make it even tougher to get anything done in Washington, D.C.?
You know, I'm not so sure about that, Charles. It's certainly a double standard is a terrible thing, and both sides regularly engage in such double standards. But in some ways, it seems the intense criticism of what is going on right now is what led Trump to finally make his decision and do this executive order rather than waiting for Congress. And of course, Congress isn't doing anything because Democrats refuse to work with Republicans right now on anything because they don't want to hand Republicans and Donald Trump a win going into the midterms. And so in a way, it's, you know, the double standard might have helped if you were worried about the situation, if you were worried about families being torn apart and that sort of thing. But, you know, I have to say, it's we don't exactly know what happened with previous administrations. I was reading a fact check, actually, on this very issue. Did President Obama's administration do the same thing? And it seems like they did not to this extent, but they actually quoted a Department of Homeland Security official saying that the Obama administration did not keep numbers on the numbers of families that were separated under this process. Sure. So it sounds like we don't actually know what happened.
But Charles, regardless, now that the president has signed this executive order, Democrats are still not happy. Now they're criticizing the president for having the parents and the kids detained together. Well, so there was it was no winning with this situation.
So let me ask you, Lawrence, knowing that that the media is against him and understanding, should President Trump or someone close to him be on guard for these sort of decisions that will make it easier to demagogue, or in this particular case, say, hey, this is an ugly image? President Trump is on record saying over and over again that this was an ugly sight to see, and yet somehow they didn't have the foresight to know that this was going to happen.
Look, I'll say this, Charles. Now that the response is coming out, even after the president signed the executive order, I almost want to say the president could have just stood by his original statement and his original policy, because obviously nothing is going to please Democrats on this issue. We want to have compassion. But again, are they going to start having the same compassion for American citizens that get ripped away from their parents when they decide to commit crimes? And the answer is no.
Guys, we have run out of time. I wish we could continue. Two of my favorite opinions, but we'll get you back soon, I'm sure. Thank you both,
Charles.
Very much.
Thanks,
we do have Republican Congressman Jody Arrington.